The gentleman Prince William, Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Speaker, I rise to ask permission to take the center aisle for a presentation. The
gentleman may proceed.
Thank you, and I would ask that our distinguished guests join me there, and any members of this body who are members of the United States Armed Forces, Active Guard, and Reserve to join me, as well as any other members of the House who may not be veterans but have a close and continuing relationship with National Guard units in your home location.
That's about everybody. The gentleman from Prince William.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I would ask that the clerk call up the resolution.
Clerk will report House Joint Resolution 385.
House Joint Resolution 385, commending the Virginia National Guard.
Gentleman from Prince William.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker and ladies and gentlemen of the House, I am joined here at the center aisle by some distinguished Americans and Virginians. They are the men and women who wear the cloth of our country as members of either the Air National Guard or the Army National Guard, and it is a privilege to welcome them to Mr. Jefferson's house. This group is led by Major General Daniel E. Long, Jr., the Adjutant General of the Commonwealth, Command Sergeant Major Dennis Green, who is the state senior enlisted leader for the Guard, Captain Rodney Rhodes, commander of the 1710th Transportation Company, and also Chief Warrant Officer 3, James Robeson, the Automotive Maintenance Supervisor for the 1710th Transportation Company. We also have a distinguished group up in the gallery seated here representing both the Army and Air National Guard components. Today, ladies and gentlemen, your National Guard here in Virginia consists of 10,000 troops, either Army, Air, or the Virginia Defense Force, serving us in a multitude of capacities. Over the last number of years since the attacks of 9/11, more than 15,000 of these men and women have deployed to foreign shores, to places where freedom faces its moment of maximum peril. And so to have them in this chamber, many of whom have done multiple deployments to hotspots throughout the world, is a true privilege. They are noted for many contributions to our Commonwealth. Just a few, the 192nd Fighter Wing, supported two overseas F-22 Raptor fighter aircraft deployments. Since 2001, more than 7,300 Virginia National Guard personnel have responded to fires and floods and hurricanes and snowstorms and other natural disasters here in the Commonwealth. Since 2013, Virginia National Guard personnel have mobilized in support of disaster relief operations during multiple events. And just this year, and within the last 2 days, many have left their homes, families, and jobs in order to contribute to the disaster relief mission in this snowstorm that we have experienced. We know here in Virginia that our airmen and soldiers are superior, but we're not the only ones that know that because they have earned multiple national recognition from many different organizations. The Virginia Beach Base 529th Combat Sustainment Support Battalion, noted for its as the highest state of readiness in the country by the National Guard Association of the United States. The Lynchburg Base 1st Battalion 116th Infantry Regiment, the most combat-ready Army National Guard battalion in the country, recognized by the Association of the United States Army. Distinguished achievements indeed, Mr. Speaker. In addition to the uniformed soldiers and airmen, the Virginia National Guard family includes a large number of individuals, a civilian workforce, families, employers, community partners, and many men and women who serve in the Virginia Defense Force and receive no pay or compensation for their volunteer service to our Commonwealth. But the most significant achievement, and the one that I wish to share with you today, fellow members of this House, is this. 150 soldiers of the Emporia-based 1710th Transportation Company deployed to Afghanistan last April 4th of 2013. And they remained there for a year in service to our nation on foreign shores. I had the privilege of attending their departure ceremony at Richard Evelyn Byrd International Airport at the invitation of General Long. Accompanying me was the distinguished gentleman from Loudoun, Mr. Ramadan, and a distinguished gentleman from Spotsylvania, Senator Reeves. And as we stood at the steps of that jetliner, as they boarded, and were able to take the hands of 130 deploying personnel from the 1710th, and to look into their eyes, what we found is we were looking full in the face of the very best that America has to offer. And that was a rare privilege. And so they have now returned home to their families. I mentioned earlier I'm joined by two distinguished individuals up here, Captain Rodney Rhodes, commander of the 1710th, and Chief Warrant Officer 3, James Robeson, the automated maintenance supervisor. And so the intersection of all of this is simply this one thing. We have a ready, reliable, relevant response force in Virginia. It's the Virginia National Guard. All of you recognize that. You have also signed on, many of you have, on this resolution supporting and commending them for their significant achievements to our country. And so I would ask that all members of this old and venerable House join me in recognizing the Virginia National Guard and its soldiers, airmen, families, and civilians, and volunteers on their splendid service to this, the greatest nation the world has ever known.
General Long, we're honored, truly honored to have you and the men and women that have served us so proudly for so many years, protecting our country and our Commonwealth, helping us. We just can't say enough to thank you and your troops, and we just appreciate you taking the time to come here and be with us today. Thank you very much.